Hello friends, the poem I'm going to share today is a well-known poem. It was also made into a short animated film which was nominated for the Oscars. So you might already be aware of this poem if you are a poetry fan, but I'll still read this poem because this is so brilliant and something that I really love. This poem is called Negative Space by Ron Korch, Negative Space. My dad taught me to pack, lay out everything, put back half, roll things that roll, wrinkle prone things on top of cotton things, then pants, waist to hem, nooks and crannies for socks, belts around the sides like snakes, plastic over that, add shoes, wear heavy stuff on the plane. We started when I was little. I'd roll up socks, then he'd pretend to put me in the suitcase, and we'd laugh. Some good guys bond with their dads shooting hoops or talking about Chevrolets. We did it over luggage. By the time I was 12, if he was busy, I'd pack for him. Mom tried but didn't have the knack. He'd get somewhere, open his suitcase and text me, "Perfect." That one word from him meant a lot. The funeral was terrible. Him laid out in that big carton and me crying and thinking, look at all that wasted space. Although this poem reads like prose, it reads like a story, and it's written also like in a very prosaic form, there's a lot of poetic device at play. Take for example, my dad taught me to pack, lay out everything, put back half. So pack and back are rhymed here. There's an internal rhyme. For another internal rhyme where I'd pack for him, mom tried but didn't have the knack. Or the simile, for example, belts around the sides like snakes. You can literally imagine, you know, a suitcase with snakes in it, and imagine, you know, the snakes in a plane. We all have watched that film. So there is a lot of poetic device that is at play. But what I really like about this poem is, of course, the title of it, Negative Space. It's not wasted space. It's not packing with papa or something. It's negative space. It creates that impact, that sense of loss of your father. You know, the space that a deceased father leaves is negative space. The title of the poem gets meaning when we read the last line of the poem. Before that, it is not revealed to us that the poet Ron Korch has lost his father. It's like we're in the middle of the funeral. All the past tense is gone. The funeral was terrible. Laid him out in that big carton and me crying and thinking, look at all that wasted space. So suddenly we are you know, at face to face with the fact that the poet has lost his father. And it almost is like the blocking technique that filmmakers use. You can literally imagine, you know, Buster Keaton pulling a gag where probably he's sitting in a boat and, you know, in a close-up he's rowing his boat, and then the camera rolls back and it is revealed that the boat is actually not in the water, it's on the land or something. So this is this blocking, hiding of information with camera is something that filmmakers do to perfection, and it's done here brilliantly in poetry, and which is a very powerful tool. And it is not just done to for the sake of making it the sense of surprise, but something much bigger is achieved through this technique in this poem. So this is the idea of losing your father, the experience of losing one's father, is a subject of poetry for many great poems. And I'd like to read a couple of more poems if possible. So there is one poem by Jerry Pinto. I think I lost the poem. Yeah, this is the poem. This poem is called Rictus by Jerry Pinto. Another brilliant poem, and this book is called 60 Indian Poets, probably one of the best anthologies of Indian English poets that you can come across. Of course, the one most known is one by edited by Arvind Krishna Mehrotra. But this is a much thicker volume and with a lot of great poetry. You can make out by the number of pages I have marked. Poems are marked, and I intend to read a couple of more poems from this anthology as the podcast progresses. So this poem is called Rictus by Jerry Pinto, a contemporary Indian poet of our times. Jerry Pinto's Rictus. The men who came to dress his body laid tender hands on his face. Their first job, they knew, was to erase that rictus of shock. Death has a grim sense of humor. One Saturday night, it tapped him on the shoulder, handed him a toy. Puzzled, he took it, shook it, he rattled. That dark red tub, my uncle's, has seen many uses. I can tell you stories, mundane ones, and some perverse, bloody horrors. You will not wash him with detergent, you will. Mummy is in the next room. I watch her between tasks. She does not react. Mention coffins and her golden eyes do not flinch. But rock salt, and she asks, why rock salt? To absorb what flows out of the body. What flows out of his body? Ordinary dreams and old fables. A few riddles, a moral or two, some gaps, the last fear. Wait one whole night, he told us, before you bury me. We did. Was there something else, Daddy? Some other instruction? Something we forgot? Here again, the fact that it's the daddy who has passed away is revealed only in the last few lines. But we can guess in a way, because mummy is in the next room and uncle has already been mentioned. So we can make out that it must be the death of his father. But I really like the way this poem flows. There's an element of humor, and rictus, the title itself is so contradictory. So this is another, I guess, one of the brilliant poems on that poets have used to come at terms with the death of one's father. There's another poem by Billy Collins which I want to share, and with this I'll end today's episode. This is another nice poem, and in terms of Freud, there is a special relationship between father and son, which has different aspects of it. It can be one of absolute love or respect, or that of being in awe of one's father, trying to draw a lot of inspiration, trying to become like one's father. It can also be a sense of, the kind of authority figure the fathers usually are, and a son trying to contest it in some sense. So this is this poem again brings out, like Rictus has a very different connotation in the poem. This again has a very different, and we can literally see how different poets have responded to the loss of one's father. This poem is called No Time, and this is again Billy Collins. I have shared two of his poems in one of the previous podcasts. So this again has the typical Billy Collins wit to it. So just short poem, again a very short piece. Just listen up. No Time. In a rush this weekday morning, I tap the horn as I speed past the cemetery where my parents lie buried side by side under a smooth slab of granite. Then all day long I think of him rising up to give me that look of knowing disapproval, while my mother calmly tells him to lie back down. Something that all of us would have experienced, our father giving us that look of knowing disapproval, while our mother calmly calming him down. So, father and mother lying side by side in a cemetery, and then father rising up, in itself is a very, it has a it has a sense of horror to it, and giving me that look of knowing disapproval. The three penultimate lines, the second stanza, is almost horror, and then it ends in a very subtle, humorous, suggestive tone, where it says, while my mother calmly tells him to lie back down. Very brilliantly put. So yeah, these are some of the poems I could think of when I read Negative Space, a poem which teaches us to come at terms with a huge loss. So yeah, do read more of Ron Coates' poem, and do read more of Jerry Pinto's and Billy Collins' poems. So yeah, we'll meet tomorrow with another poem and another poet and a new discussion. Thank you so much for being a part of today's episode, today's podcast, and do read a lot of poetry, because poetry has a way of calming us and making us realize what life is actually about. Yeah, thank you so much.